Hello everyone. This is part 3 video, how to create the sample form design with FlatLaugh. So in this part we going to display the employee, and then update and delete. So in previous part we has insert data to database. Here we have data in table employee, so next we going to select this all data and display into the table. Go to service employee and create new method here to get all data. For this method we return list of model employee. But we can copy code from service positions. And we need change the SQL query here. We select from table employee and join with table positions. Then get all field from these table. And change this to model employee. Then go to main form and create new method to load the data. To add row to table we need create default table model. And check if table current editing, we need stop the cell editing, because we need remove all table row after add new row from database. Here remove all row by use method set row count to 0. Now create list of model employee. And call service.getAll. Then create for loop, and add it into the table model. But we need the array object for table row, so we need go to class model employee, and create new method for table row. Create method to table row, and return as the array object, and we need the row number. Create date format object to format date. And number format for format salary. Now set data in this array, the first column as Boolean type, so by default we set false to unselected. This for row number. And for index 2 we set as this object. So if we set the cell as the employee object like this, we need override method to string to display field that we want. So we return name for display at column index 2. Then we can use method to table row here. And we need row number, so we can set as table row count plus 1. So go here, after connect to database, we call this method to load the data. But we get error with the column positions ID. Here we set wrong in query here. Now we have display data in table, so next we going to create the search data from this text field. Copy this method and create new for search data. Change to search, and we have one parameter for search text. And change query here, we add where condition. We can search by position's name. Or by employee name. Or by description. Or location. So this query need 4 parameters, so we need pass this search to all. Then go to main form again. We need create new method for search. We can copy from method load data here. Change it to search data. And change get all method to search. Now go to this text field and add event key release. Here, we can search the employee. So next we're going to create function to edit employee. By go to service employee, and create new method to edit. We can copy from create method. And change SQL query here. And we need add one more parameter here for employee ID that we want to edit. Then go to main form, and in button edit here. First we need get the selected row, to get data from table that user has select for edit. So user can select more row, so we need return as list. Then loop all row, to get the row that's selected. We check the first index, because the first index we set as checkbox. So if row selected, we get the object model employee from that row. For column of this object, we can check in method to table row. Here we use this at column index 2. Then add this object to list. So here in event button edit, we can get data that user selected. And we need check is list not empty, it mean user not select any row. Else, we show the message notification to the user. And we need check is user select only one row. Else, we also show notification. Here when we select multi rows like this, it show notification, please select one employee. Then here we can edit employee here, by first we get one from list. And create the object create. Call method to load the data. And we want to display the employee that user select to the form create. So here in method load data, we can set new model employee here. And we need check if this data not null, we display all information to the input. For SQL date we can convert to local date. And when we add positions object to comma box, we can check here to select the position that user edit. Here we can use method setSelectedItem. So back to main form, and here when we call method loadData we need set the employee that user selected. And for create we set null. And then here we need show the pop-up. So we can copy code from this. And change this to edit. We create object edit here. And change this. But we see in form create, we return new model employee that set as ID 0. So here before edit, we need set employee ID to this object. Employee ID that we set as ID that user select to update. Then change notification message. And pop-up title, we can set the employee name. And change action button to update. So when we create new, it's no data to fill, but when we edit. Here we have default data and employee name as the title, so we can edit it. So we update success, and we go to check data in table. Here data updated. So next we going to delete the employee. Go to service employee, create new method for delete. So we can copy from this method. For delete we need only employee ID. And change the query here to delete. Remove all this, and set parameter as ID. So next back to main form, create event to delete button. And we need copy from this code, to get employee that user selected. And this when list is empty. And then copy the show pop-up. And remove this. Then create new JLabel for pop-up message. We need change the border. Then add this label to show pop-up. And change the title. And change this to delete. User can select more row to delete, so we delete it by using loop. So here after delete we need load data again. And change action button to delete. Here data has deleted. But we see the checkbox still selected, so we also need update this checkbox when delete row. So go back to class checkbox table header renderer. And here the method check row, we need and one more condition for data deleted. So add new employee for test. But we forget to load data after created. We can call here. Thank you everyone for watching. See you next video.